All dinosaurs, even the biggest ones, come from small eggs. And that is where my story begins. I was born on the night of an exceptionally beautiful full moon. As if the moonlight cast a shadow, my face was covered in spots. That's why I'm called Speckles.
Mom is a Tarbosaurus. She has four younglings. A 10-year-old son, Quix. 6-year-old twin girls. And me. The super cute 1-year-old Spotty Face. Stalking her prey. Today, our prey is the herbivorous Tyrannosaurus. We are the best hunters in the forest. I think they just finished the strategy meeting and are about to set out. Without me, again! Oh, can I come too? It would be so wonderful to hunt with them! I gotta watch closely from now. They're about to begin. Quix starts off by stalking the prey while avoiding the watchful eye of the guards. Ambush! Three Tyrannosauruses away from the herd. He drives them towards the twins. He's awesome! He is the best chaser in the world! Ah! The twins take over. Joint operation of brother and sisters. And Mom's final strike. Yeah, they got it. This is how my family hunts. We're Tarbosauruses, the kings of the forest. I'm so proud of my family. Our nest sits on a spot looking over the entire forest. My sisters like to play together, but they never invite me. I don't care. It's pretty lame anyway. No different. It's hard being the youngest. I love roaming the forest with my brothers and sisters. For a curious little dinosaur, it's full of fascinating things. Huh? It's a Repanomamus. A plump and furry field mouse. It's a perfect toy for me. They must be his mom and dad. Oh, their moms give birth, but us dinosaurs lay eggs. Isn't that fascinating? Huh? What's that? A massive dinosaur. It's eating gravel to help with digestion. Must be a Therizinosaurus. Oops. Mom said I should be careful. Quicks! this clawed creature hates being bothered. Not quite the friendliest fella. That Tyrannosaurus lost an eye? Where did he come from? Haven't seen him around before. That's an Ankylosaurus rubbing his body against a rock. He's itching from the maggots that dug into its hard skin. He's a herbivore, but no one messes with him. Because his tail hammer can shatter you to pieces. One Eye turned out to be a scary and horrible monster. This is so exciting! I don't care what Quick says. Today, I'm going on my first hunt. Yes! My time has finally come. Now, I'm a proud member of Family Hunters. I badgered Mom to let me join in. Quix wasn't pleased, but no one can stop me. Oh, don't worry, Mom. Soon, I'll be a better chaser than him. I know what Quix is after. It's obvious, those little ones hanging by the shore. What? Come on, I could ambush them first. Come! I'm gonna go for the bigger prey. And unlike my brother... I'll take you on! I'm the Great Speckles!
Thank you.
I barely stayed alive. It was so hard for me to come out for some water. Huh? The Microraptors! Scare the heck out of me! Not long ago, they were easily my toys. But look at me now. I'm the biggest coward. Those are velociraptors. Outlaws traveling in packs. They'll eat me up to the bone if they catch me. These pterosaurs live on top of cliffs. Mommy pterosaurs guard their eggs all day. What should I do? But I can't give up. I gotta have one of those eggs, or I'll die of starvation. This is so good! I haven't eaten in a week! Oops! Velociraptors, again! The Hypsilophodon is being chased by the Velociraptors. It's pretty much the end for you once those bullies get to you. A monster living underneath? It swallowed them up. How scary is the monster living beneath the muck? I better be careful. Hungry and tired, I return to my family's old nest. I can almost see Mom greeting me with a smile. I miss you, Mom. My brother, Quix, and my sisters. I forgot about One Eye for a moment. That beast has now taken over our nest. If I have a taste? I haven't had any meat in such a long time.
I struggled to survive. The idea of avenging my family seemed so far off. Just 5 years old. I'm only a weak little dinosaur. I was watching two giant males engaged in a fight. Oh, and One Eye was watching too. Even my family stayed clear of Torosauruses, who have horns over 3 feet long. In order to win the females and younglings, the young male mounted a challenge to the existing leader. The aging leader loses his horns, and is ousted. It's the opportunity that One Eye was waiting for. You're getting your butt kicked, One Eye. The Therizino never forgives anyone trespassing his territory. Go, Therizino! Show him what you got! One Eye pulls a dirty trick on him. Who is that? That fool, coveting One Eye's catch? It's got blue eyes. Well, thanks, Blue Eyes. It's that Blue Eyes. Huh? What's up with that? Huh. Poor thing. Must be as starved as I am. Blue Eyes was a female Tarbosaurus. Finally, I've made a friend. Wow! These are Poogyungosauruses. These 65-foot-tall, massive sauropods live alongside Nemecolopteruses, small pterosaurs, which eat the ticks from the giant's skin and help relieve itchiness. They live symbiotically. Helping each other, like Blue Eyes and I will.
I turned 10. Now I'm as tall as Quix used to be. Blue Eyes and I moved far away from One Eye and have been staying together, hunting as a team. I chase the target. And Blue Eyes ambushes. We're a fantastic team. This is the swamp where the scary monster lives. And it's our secret hunting ground. How did One Eye get here? The monster that killed my family. But I'm still no match for him. Blue Eyes, no! What do I do? Yes, that'll work. Okay, steady. A little more. No! Yeah! That's it. Gotcha. Adios, you one-eyed slime ball. We were thrilled. We finally got rid of One Eye. What a persistent beast! Seems nothing can stop him. Blue Eyes and I had to move again, far away from One Eye's reach. We needed hope. Those guys, where are they going?
Wow. Look at this place. Steam arose from the water. It was a hot spring. The water was warm and soothing. The itchiness went away, and Blue Eye's injury healed. The hot spring was our healing ground. Blue Eyes and I moved to a new forest, away from One Eye. The forest comes alive during the mating season. For long now, we'd forgotten about One Eye. I turned 20, and I've grown into a robust young male. I managed to corner a Torosaurus. He'll take his last shot at getting away. But unfortunately for him, I'm the best hunter. Speckles. Blue Eyes and I, we were happy as can be in our new nest. We'll be a family once our hatchlings are born. Huh. Yep, One Eye was back. He came all the way out here, looking for a mate. I won't let you get away this time. But I froze at the sound of his thundering roar. I hadn't gotten over my fear of him. Blue Eyes! No, Blue Eyes! Get up! Come on, Blue Eyes. Watching Blue Eyes on the ground brought back bitter memories from the past. No, not again. Filthy beast! I defeated him! Finally, I got my family's old nest back. Mom, Quicks, sisters, I'm back. For one entire month, Blue Eyes stood guard without budging. And after all that time, our hatchlings came into the world. But because it's a difficult time for hatching, only two out of all the eggs hatched. Then, something incredible happened. With a face covered with spots just like mine, Speckles Jr. was born. The Cretaceous period was coming to its end. Our peaceful world was changing slowly. But I didn't notice anything because I was living in the happiest moment. Suddenly, the ground shook. A volcano erupted. Day turned into night. From the darkness, balls of fire poured down upon us. To abandon our nest. No! My baby!
guys! Get up! Hurry! Hurry!
It went on for 2 weeks. The forests were destroyed. We lost everything and left. Everyone was exhausted from thirst and hunger. And the velociraptors. Horrible creeps followed us everywhere. Eyes. You're hurt, and we came too far. Get up, Blue Eyes. We saw what happened to the fallen Bugyongosaurus. Velociraptors. These merciless carcass cleaners are waiting for weakened dinosaurs to fall. Wake up, Blue Eyes. Come on, you creeps. I was getting exhausted, but they kept on coming. Thank you.
completely surrounded. Give up. Blue eyes. Blue eyes. No. Let's go. We continue forward, leaving her behind. I have to, for the sake of the children. Two more weeks passed. It felt like the desert would never end.
Then, a miracle happened. Dinosaurs in the front let out a cry of joy. We hurried along. And there, on the far horizon, we saw a green paradise. But the way to paradise wasn't easy. There was a final hurdle waiting for us. It was a narrow path leading to paradise. We walked on that dangerous path. The young ones looked curiously at the ocean. Then suddenly, a herd of dinosaurs were rushing toward us. Childhood nightmare came back. I can't lose my family again like this. One Eye, again? How did he get here? An evil fate brought him back to me. Hundreds of miles from home, on the edge of a cliff, I stood face to face with One Eye once again. Let's finish this thing off.
Junior!
Junior! The youngest survived. No! I must save him, no matter what. Dinosaurs came, smelling blood. Those disgusting 100-foot-long sea monsters. Gotta get to him fast. Junior, where are you? Junior! I was fast becoming exhausted. Gotta save my child.
I must get over there, no matter what. Junior, my cute baby. I have a wish that the place I reach with my son will be thick with green leaves, and that only happy stories will continue.